Hello everyone, this is Justin, an application specialist at Roctek International, and today we'll be going over how to input the basic building blocks of any takeoff. Let's jump right in. To start, we'll use the most basic building block of any takeoff, the contour line. Located along the top, in this bottom row, are our basic inputs. The leftmost one, the T, is our contour line. We select this. We can select existing or proposed. We'll select existing, and we'll pick an elevation to start with. You'll notice that our job range is still set here from 0 to 35. We'll select the 30 existing topo in the top left corner. So 30, select OK, and you'll notice we have the pencil back to go ahead and input that topo. However, we'll probably want to center our view, so we have two options. We can select the hand tool to enter pan mode, left click, hold, drag the screen, and then let go to move the screen. And then we can simply select the hand tool again to re-enter the input mode, or if your mouse has a middle mouse scroll wheel, you can press it in as if it were a button to toggle between the two. From here, we'll start at the beginning of the line, and we'll left click, hold, and drag along the line. Once we have that set, we'll select New Topo. You'll notice these options along here. Next Elevation and New Elevation. We'll select New first, and then we'll type out the elevation of the next topo in our interval. The next one is 25, so we'll type out 25, select OK, and we'll draw that as well. Now we could continue selecting new elevation, but since we've selected 30 and then 25, we can simply select next elevation along this interval to continue at the 5 foot elevation difference. From here, we can simply left click or left click and drag and finish all of our topos. Let's go ahead and fast forward through the existing and the proposed topos. If you make a mistake, remember, you can backspace to delete points and then continue on down the line. Go ahead and complete the rest and pause the video while you do so. Now that we have our topos entered, it's time to move on to the four major regions displayed. We have a driveway, a parking lot, a do not disturb area, and a pad. Let's start with the driveway. In order to input this, we'll start with our region located here. We'll select a region with subgrades. We'll go ahead and name this region. And we can change the color if necessary. And then select OK. From here, just like with the contours, left click across straight edges and drag and hold the left mouse button in order to use line tracker. You'll notice that it will display the shading as you are entering the line. And again, just like the total work area, this is a closed region, so it will automatically close the first and last points. Select Finish to enter the region options. From here, if we wanted to strip this area further from the previous 4 inches, we could. However, we want to add subgrades. To do that, we can select Subgrades and Balancing and select the Proposed Subgrade Materials option. From here, we can add subgrades by clicking Add and use our drop-down list to enter Asphalt and then enter Crushed Stone. It will keep asking for subgrade layers as long as you keep adding them. Select Close to finish. And if you plan on using this type of subgrade materials often for the similar type of regions, go ahead and give it a name, such as Light Duty Paving, and select the Save option. Now you'll be able to select that from a drop-down menu for any other similar areas. And then select OK. And then select Done. You'll notice that we'll be adjusting the proposed grades down by 10 inches in this area, Because we know you'll be bringing in materials. Alright, go ahead and complete the parking lot as well. Do note that this parking lot has islands. While entering a region, you'll see further options located here, one of which will be a subtract area. Select the subtract area to remove island 1, and then select it again to remove island 2, and select finish. This concludes part 1 of the basic inputs. Please stick around to finish up part 2 and complete the takeoff.